Hello, good day, children. In the past lesson, we discussed more about blogging, how to create an account and post and share materials on blog in a safe and responsible manner. Today, we are going to define video conferencing, identify the communication devices used in video conferencing, give examples of video conferencing applications, and participate in video and audio conferences in a safe and responsible manner. But before we continue, please subscribe, like, and share this video. Video conferencing, also called as teleconferencing or web conferencing, is an online meeting wherein two or more people can see, hear, and talk to each other using computer networks to send audio and video data in real time. Some examples of video conferencing application that allows direct video and voice communication via internet are: Number 1. Zoom. Zoom is one of the most popular video conferencing solution for businesses. It is feature-rich with various plans based on business size and needs. The features for enterprise-level plan include up to 200 meeting participants, unlimited cloud storage, custom emails and vanity meeting URL, and more. Number 2. Google Hangouts. Hangout is often considered to be an individual use service, not as feature-rich as other commercial and enterprise-ready services. However, for small businesses or those that fully leverage use it across their operations, Hangouts can be an effective tool for video communication. The cost can be low, depending on your team G Suite subscription, which start as low as $6 per month per user. Number 3. Google Meet. Created for enterprise customers, Google Meet is an upgraded version of Google Hangouts. Google Meet is designed around scheduled video meetings among team members, with similar features to Zoom like calendar sensing, conference room booking, and more polished user interface. Number 4. Skype for Business. Microsoft's popular Skype service is augmented as an enterprise-ready video conferencing tool. It has several business features such as allowing up to 250 attendees in a meeting and connection with other Skype users and virtual whiteboarding capabilities. Number 5. Messenger Rooms. Facebook is rolling out a video calling feature called Messenger Rooms. It allows you and up to 49 others to join a group video call, which Facebook calls a room. You'll be able to start a room from Messenger, Facebook, Instagram Direct, WhatsApp, or portals, and you can open the call to all or lock it to stop uninvited people from joining. You can remove participants too. While in a room, you can use Facebook augmented reality filters and change out your background to a virtual one. Facebook is including 360 degrees views of exotic location for backgrounds, and it's working on beauty filters as well as filters design to brighten a dark room. Number 6. GoToMeeting. GoToMeeting has many useful features, including instant meeting or meeting scheduling, meeting transcription services, and app meeting messaging between participants. GoToMeeting pricing start at $14 per month for groups of up to 10 meeting participants and cost $29 per month for larger groups of 150 participants. Number 7. Microsoft Teams. Host audio, video, and web conferences with anyone. Get features such as scheduling assistance, meeting note-taking, screen sharing, meeting recording, and instant messaging. Hold any meeting live, large meetings, webinars, company-wide events, and presentation with up to 10,000 attendees inside or outside your organization with Teams. Let people join meetings on the go with global dial-in number or contact each other directly. All they need is a mobile device and a Teams. Here are the requirements for using the video conferencing. Computer with a good access to the internet, a browser, a speakers, headset or headphones, a microphone, and a web camera. Video conferencing is widely used in different fields from homes, schools, to business establishments. At home, it helps families and friends to stay connected to loved ones from different places in and out of the country. In school, it may enable students to see each other, share documents, and discuss lecture even if they are in different cities or even countries. It may also allow virtual field trip. In businesses, video conferencing is efficient to use not only during meetings but also when dealing with customers. Product demonstration, for instance, may be executed more effectively through video conferencing rather than explaining it verbally. The following are the benefits of using video conferencing. It reduces travel time and expenses since it allows people to communicate to several places in an instant without having to leave the office. It allows people from different fields and places to easily collaborate and share ideas with each other. And it enables showing demonstration or procedures to large audience that may come from several places from all over the world. There are so-called e-groups, also known as online or web communities. These groups of people who use internet services such as email, chat systems, discussion boards, and social networking sites to communicate and collaborate with one another. It is a convenient way to share messages, photos, and ideas to keep people with same interest to stay connected. Investors, clients, and business partners can all use web conferencing as an important tool regardless of their location. The major benefits of web conferencing include saving time, resources, and money since you and your clients or customer can meet online instead of having to leave the office. It is also environmentally friendly since it reduces the need for travel. This method of communication can be just as effective as an actual in-person meeting if it is conducted correctly. That's all for today's class. Now, please answer the following questions.